right. So in continuance here, I'm talking now about, because I was talking of short partners, and now I'm going on to wondering, you know, what happened to my career. And so I go back now 30 years. I go back 30 years, and I'm looking directly at Karbonikov. He was defector from Russia, and I believe he had the tunic. He had a beautiful tunic from Kirov, and he danced with me there. This silly, ridiculous snow queen, fairy, snow king. And in this moment, he was shot on stage. It is a moment of wonder. At the very end of Pas de Deux, total collapse. He totally collapsed. The next moment of the next day, next performance, he appears with the dressing on his shoulder. So I believe he was shot, but I'm not sure if he was shot before the performance or during the performance. I don't have the exact. I didn't ask him because I was quite young and quite impressionable at, oh my gosh, he's a man from Kirov, I dance with men from Kirov. And so I did not ask him. However, I believe he was injured quite greatly. And in that moment when he was shot, as I will say, it's very possible he was shot right there during the very end of the finale moment of the pressage. It was a very grand pressage for a long time, and there was much moment to shoot him. He dropped me. He fell also, literally conked out to an unconscious state. And so I dragged him off the stage, like literally. I didn't drag him like a he-woman, but I did actually take him as the leader, you know. I took him as the leader off the stage into the wings. And so in this moment, I believe he could have very been much so sucked into an unconscious state that I had to drag him out of it. So if the shot happened during the performance, it happened during the performance. If it happened before, the night before, it's possible. It's also possible. So I don't have exact, you know, if you want to go back to memoir time, I don't have exact. All I know is I remember he had the dressing on his shoulder in his garderobe in his dressing room. It looked like he had been to a doctor or something. For the next performance. So there we are. So that was my big moment, you know, dancing with Man of Kirov, and he was pretty much a defector, direct defector from, I believe there was a company there in Mexico at the time, and they dropped out, he dropped out then. They traveled to Mexico, and he dropped out at that moment. So I don't know, artistic reasons. I believe it was artistic reasons, but maybe he thought nobody would miss him and his beautiful tunic. But perhaps that was another thought. Maybe they missed him quite greatly, quite greatly, that you don't leave. You actually don't ever leave, you know. And so maybe that's what happened. And I believe they hurt his shoulder there for partnering. I don't know what else to say, but it appears it did look like a Russian connection, aggravation back at him. So maybe that is why. Maybe that is why nobody wanted to dance with me. They're afraid they're going to be shot on the stage. So I had that humor at least. Yeah. Perhaps that is an assistance reason as to why. As to why I continue. Yeah. So thank you, Mr. Dimitri, for that one. That was very cute. That's very cute. I hope your shoulder is okay. But 30 years ago, my God. I don't know. I thought he was a beautiful dancer. I thought he was a beautiful dancer. I don't know. They say he was a clown. I think he was still quite a prince, quite much a prince. So not a problem, not a problem. However, once you do shoot a person in the shoulder, and their job is to lift females, it could be quite a danger to his career. So, but I think he could still teach beautiful. So anyway, if you want to write that down in your book, I'm not sure, everybody, in your memoir book, what happened to Dimitri. What happened? He could have been shot before the performance or during. That's really where I'm at with that particular. All right? It wasn't because I was too fat. It wasn't that reason. It wasn't because he was tired because he drank vodka. No, he was really injured. He was really injured by a weapon of war. So, anyway, so there it goes, Mr. Mrs. Defector back then. I guess it was dangerous. I guess it was dangerous still. It was a beautiful tunic. It was a beautiful tunic. One of the most beautiful I've ever seen.